For decades, the bicycle derailleur has ruled the drivetrain world, and for good reason. It's lightweight, efficient, affordable, and compatible with nearly every bike on the market. But what if conventional derailleurs are holding us back? After all, they hang low and exposed, making them easy targets for rocks, sticks, and crashes. In this video, we're taking a close look at Supre Drive, a radical new drivetrain that reimagines the derailleur system from the ground up. Designed for durability, reliability, and quiet performance, Supre Drive promises to fix many of the issues that cyclists have come to accept as inevitable. We'll explore how Supre works, weigh its pros and cons against regular derailleurs and pinion gearboxes, and we'll ask the big question: is this the future of the mountain bike drivetrain? At first glance, Supre Drive looks weird, complex, and inefficient. But when you drill down into the details, it's not as crazy as it appears. Supre essentially splits the two main functions of a derailleur, the shifting and the chain tensioning. A small derailleur shifts the chain across the cassette sprockets just like normal, but the chain tensioning is now conducted near the front sprocket. Supre requires one extra pulley wheel compared to a regular derailleur drivetrain. This does add to the overall drive resistance, but it's kept within 1% thanks to the large diameter pulleys that minimize the chain articulation angles. Surprisingly, Supre Drive uses many standard components, including a Shimano 12-speed shifter, chain, and cassette. The crankset, bottom bracket, and rear hub spacing are all somewhat normal too. The rest of the components are engineered and manufactured by a small company called Lau Bikes in Canada. Supre can be fitted to hardtail bikes and full suspension bikes that are designed around a high pivot. I got the chance to test this drivetrain against a high-end derailleur on two otherwise identical bikes. Here are the key advantages I've identified over SRAM transmission. The most obvious advantage of Supre Drive is that it lifts your derailleur out of harm's way, protecting your drive components from rocks, logs, and crashes. This minimizes the frequency of broken components, keeping your bike out of the workshop and on the trail. More importantly, Supre Drive delivers reliable shifting because its design makes misalignment virtually impossible. This is a major benefit for 12-speed systems, where even slight misalignment can lead to poor shift performance. It's also ideal for riders who frequently transport their bikes and don't want to stress about damaging an expensive derailleur. That's whether you toss your bike in a car or into a box if you fly regularly. A well-protected drivetrain might also change the way you ride. I don't know about you, but I usually take derailleur protective lines on super technical trails. But with Supre Drive, I never worried about tagging my $500 derailleur on a rock. My favorite feature is the hydraulic chain tensioner, which, along with the very short section of loose chain, makes Supre Drive the most silent derailleur drivetrain I've ever tested. The chain tensioner lives inside the frame and doesn't require any maintenance. It also only adds chain tension in accordance with how fast the chain is bouncing. On rough terrain, where the chain rattles a lot, the tensioner provides more force, keeping your bike quiet. And when slowly climbing up a hill, it provides less force, allowing for smoother shifts. In comparison, a regular derailleur uses a one-way clutch to prevent your chain from rattling. These clutches often rely on sliding friction, making them especially prone to wear. The Supre tensioner is unlikely to wear out due to its sealed, oil-damp design. The combination of high ground clearance and high chain tension under a large impact also keeps your chain from slapping on the ground. This means your chain ultimately accumulates less grit. Check out these screenshots from a pink bike huck to flat video to see the difference. This high chain clearance is notably beneficial in the snow too. Another clear advantage is the straighter chain line across the gears. The idler pulley is set further forward than the front sprocket, resulting in a long upper chain span that reduces the chain angle at the extremes. This minimizes chain noise, drive resistance, and wear. A full suspension bike can also perform better with Supre, as there is 300 grams less unsprung mass at the rear wheel. This results in your rear shock being able to react quicker to impacts, providing more traction and performance. Okay, so Supre Drive offers several tangible advantages over a regular derailleur, but there are some notable disadvantages to consider too. Firstly, if you'd like to use this drivetrain, you'd need to invest in an entirely new bike. Supre requires a specially designed frame with mounts for the derailleur, hydraulic damper, and upper pulley. This is not without precedent. When you buy a bike with a pinion gearbox, you also need to commit to a dedicated gearbox frame. That said, when a frame is designed to accommodate both a Supre rear triangle and a standard one, it enables compatibility for both drivetrain types, giving manufacturers and consumers the most options. Supre Drive places some constraints on pivot placement in full suspension frames. This would require many bike brands to rethink their preferred suspension linkage designs to ensure they would all fit around the drive components. Another drawback is that it doesn't work with mid-drive e-bike motors. As the e-bike market continues to grow, especially among riders who are open to new tech, this incompatibility further limits Supre Drive's potential reach. Without the ability to serve this fast-expanding segment, it becomes harder for this drivetrain to gain widespread adoption. Supre Drive holds a weight penalty over regular derailleur drivetrains. Previous bike builds have shown it's about 400 grams, or 1 pound heavier. The shift speed is also marginally slower, as there's a bit more chain wrap around the cassette. Supre Drive is currently cost prohibitive. Not only do you need a specialist frame, but you need a whole bunch of made-in-Canada components. And lastly, spare parts are currently only available through Lel Bikes in Canada. This could make repairs more challenging, and it raises concerns about long-term support if the company were to ever shut down. Okay, you should now have a good idea whether Supre Drive is for you. So, where can you buy it? At the moment, there's just one bike built to accommodate Supre Drive. It's called the Lel Katana, and it won't be hitting the trails until 2026. This 130mm travel all-mountain frame is designed and manufactured by the creator of Supre Drive, and it features a slightly rearward axle path that helps it carry momentum more effectively over square edge bumps. Lel Bikes hopes this proof of concept will convince bike manufacturers that their drivetrain is worthy of investment. Let's now shift gears and compare Supre Drive against the venerable Pinion gearbox. Supre Drive offers numerous advantages over a Pinion gearbox, making it especially appealing for riders focused on performance. For starters, bikes equipped with Supre Drive can be up to a kilogram lighter than their Pinion-equipped counterparts, giving riders an immediate advantage in terms of weight savings. When it comes to drive efficiency, Supre performs similarly to regular derailleur drivetrains, even surpassing many high pivot setups. In contrast, pinion gearboxes have been measured to lose between 5 and 7% of pedal power in a controlled lab test, making Supre Drive the quickest option. Moreover, Supre Drive allows for gear changes under a full pedal load, a feature that sets it apart from gearbox drivetrains, which require a slight reduction in pedal force. Additionally, Supre Drive offers faster drivetrain engagement as it only has one free wheel. In comparison, gearbox bikes feel more sluggish as they must engage one free wheel at the gearbox and another at the rear hub. Beyond performance, Supre Drive is mechanically simple and easy to maintain. Gear adjustments are made at the shifter, and replacement parts like chains and cassettes are easily found at most bike shops. There's also no need to send away components for maintenance, unlike with a gearbox. And lastly, although Supre Drive comes at a premium price, it remains more affordable than a Pinion gearbox bike, at least in the short term. Pinion gearboxes are the easy choice for cyclists seeking a low-maintenance drivetrain that significantly reduces component wear. Thanks to their sealed gear components, gearbox drivetrains are virtually maintenance-free. In addition, the internal gear indexing eliminates the need for gear adjustments and makes gear skipping a thing of the past. Another advantage of gearboxes is the compatibility with belt drives, which further reduces maintenance needs. With a belt drivetrain, there's far less cleaning and lubrication, and the components last much longer, often 3 to 4 times longer than a chain. Even if you stick with chains, the perfectly straight chain line of a gearbox bike still leads to longer lasting components. On top of that, gearboxes allow for instant gear changes, even without pedaling. This unique feature enables you to shift gears while cornering, while stationary, and even in the air. Without the bulk of a heavy cassette and derailleur at the rear wheel, gearbox bikes also offer improved suspension performance. The reduced unsprung mass allows the suspension to react faster to impacts, providing better traction. And lastly, Pinion gearboxes offer a wider gear range, which is ideal for riders who need both low gears for steep climbs and higher gears for fast descents. With the advantages and disadvantages now laid out, and a comparison made against gearboxes, the question is, will this drivetrain gain wider appeal? For Supre Drive to gain wider appeal, bike manufacturers must go all in on an extremely niche drivetrain without even knowing whether consumers will actually buy it. This is a massive risk for a bike manufacturer. The market conditions for taking on this risk are not particularly favorable right now. The bike industry is currently sitting on a lot of stock, and demand for bicycles is quite low after the recent COVID boom. In addition, bike manufacturers usually prefer to buy their drivetrain, brakes, and suspension components in bulk from suppliers, as they get a large discount and more payment flexibility. This all sounds a bit bleak, but there's a silver lining here. Supre Drive would be a unique selling point for a bike brand, and a great way for up-and-coming brands to stand out. I'd imagine smaller companies could get a strong foothold in the market by using an innovative new drivetrain with genuine performance benefits. A good case study is Priority Bicycles, whose unique selling point is the belt and gearbox drivetrains found on all of their bikes. While being a very small company, differentiating themselves in a market flooded with products has allowed them to grow quickly and establish themselves as a reputable brand. There is no reason why other new bike brands couldn't do the same with Supre Drive. So, is Supre Drive the future of mountain bike drivetrains? With its smart rethinking of the derailleur, Supre Drive brings real benefits, like enhanced durability, better reliability, and quieter performance, all while keeping things relatively simple and serviceable. It's not all perfect though, as Supre requires a dedicated frame design, it doesn't work with mid-drive e-bike motors, and the bike options are limited for now. Ultimately, the success of this drivetrain depends on whether the bike industry can recognize its potential to drive bike sales. So leave a comment below and let the bike industry know whether you'd be prepared to buy a Supre Drive bike. After testing this drivetrain, I hope that I have a Supre Drive bike in the coming years. I'll see you guys soon.